Hey everyone! So today I'm going to show you how to customize your own loose powder. If you want to know more, please stay tuned. Hey guys, welcome back. So let me tell you about loose powders. For women like me, it's really hard to look for a loose powder that's perfect for my skin tone. It's either it's dark, it becomes dark after a while, or it's too light. I don't really use translucent powders because they tend to get white when, especially on flash photography. But I don't have anything against translucent powders. That's just my opinion. It's actually pretty easy to customize your own loose powder because most likely you already know what is lacking with your current loose powder. I'm going to show you three powders that I mix to customize my own loose powder. When I put on liquid foundation, I found out that it's better to set it with loose powder than pressed powder because the less that it cakes, because you can control the amount of powder that you put on your face. This is my old loose powder container. It's actually from Kanebo. I used Kanebo like 5 years ago, and I really love the container because it has that thing. So I kept it, and this is where I mix my powder. And then you're going to need a spatula. It doesn't have to be a steel one. You can use any spatula that you want. Anything that you can mix your powder with. I really like Fashion 21's loose powder. I think that the coverage is really nice, but they don't have it in my color. I know that it looks that it matches, but when I put it on my face, because of the acidity, it becomes orange. I like using Trublend minerals because when you put it on, it has a little bit of shimmer, so your face looks glowing. I mean, not your face, but your skin looks. It gives the illusion that your skin is very dewy. And then I have this body shimmer powder from Nichido. The particles, the glitter particles, are actually bigger. But I like adding that on to have that extra shine to the face. So let's begin. So I'm gonna use the cap as my mixing bowl of sorts. So what I did is I removed the strainer on my powders, so I can easily scoop out some products if I need some more product. Now I'm going to start mixing. So I'm going to start with my base color, which is Fashion 21's number one loose powder. The reason why I like this powder is because it has like a medium to full coverage, and it's yellow based, so that's why I like using it. So I'm going to take about that much. I'm going to start with just a little product just to get the colors right, and then just remember the proportions that you put into your mixing bowl so that you can always double that. And then I'm going to take my Trublend minerals from Covergirl. I'm going to get about half of what I put in the, then just mix that. When you're mixing your loose powder, for example, you found a really nice loose powder that you fell in love with. If you find that it's a bit too light or too dark, then you look for like a darker shade or a lighter shade that's yellow based, because the yellow color will actually blend the two colors together. So now I have the right color, the right shade for me. So I'm just gonna try that. Your loose powder should match your skin perfectly. It has to complement with your liquid foundation. Because if you have a dark foundation and then your loose powder is light, then it will clash. It has to match perfectly. They have to complement each other. So now that I have the color right, I'm going to add a little bit of shimmer powder. Just a little, so I don't want to look too greasy. Really disappear on your skin. Now it's perfect. Just a quick tip on how to make your loose powders more fine. I like using extra fine loose powder to set my foundation because I found that the less it cakes and you don't look that thick, your makeup doesn't look that thick, so it sets the foundation and you have the right color, but it doesn't look cakey and, you know, it doesn't look muddy. What I did is, like, I bought a mortar and pestle, a plastic one. You can basically buy that anywhere. What you do is, like, you put your loose powder and then you just start pounding it for about maybe 5 minutes. And then I bought an extra fine strainer and then I strained it like you would with flour. And I found that it becomes, like, really light and feathery. Like, it has the consistency of HD powder, but it has color. For those of you who are curious about my makeup look today, I basically used a light foundation and I set it with my personalized loose powder. And then I used just a nude shimmer shadow as a base on my eyes. And I contoured that with Fanny Serrano's single eyeshadow in this one, in Espresso. It's a beautiful mahogany type. Shade. It's not really brown. It's actually like a little bit of a deep apricot, which I really like. So I contoured that. I added my eyeliner using K palette, and then I put on false eyelashes. I didn't put anything on my cheeks because I already have a strong eye makeup look. For my lips, I put on lip concealer and this lovely shade of pink. It's Precious Pout. It's Precious Pout from Snoe. So guys, I hope that you learned something about mixing your own loose powder. When you do this technique, you will find that it has a lot of benefits. You can just use a BB cream, which is like, it has a very thick consistency, so you don't want to add extra weight to your face. The loose powder can actually set that without looking too made up. So anyway, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. The subscribe button is like above me, I think. So hit that and you'll be subscribed to more videos coming soon. If you have beauty questions, I would be more than happy to answer them. Just send me an email at sabshernandez@gmail.com. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you soon.